बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। टुडेज़ टॉपिक इज लाइकिंग कांड। लाइकिंग पैनस और क्लासिकल लाइकिंग पैनस इज द इन्फ्लेमेटरी कंडीशन ऑफ स्किन दैट प्रेजेंट विद टिपिकली प्रूरिटिक पॉलीगोनल पर्पल पेप्यूल्स एंड प्लाक्स विच आर प्लेन टॉप। सो वी यूज 5 P's टू डिस्क्राइब लाइकिंग पैनस। प्रेवलेंस इज नॉट दैट लो, 0.5 to 1%। वेरियस एटियोलॉजिकल एजेंट्स are implicated like drugs, quinine in tonic water, over-the-counter leg cramp medicine, allergy to metals in fillings and oral appliances for oral lichen planus, then hepatitis C virus and hepatitis B immunization both in case of generalized lichen planus. If the eruption is due to exposure to metals, chemicals or drugs, symptoms usually resolve a few weeks to month after eliminating the exposure, but may still recur intermittently over time. Variants in morphology and location exist, including lichen planus of hairs, nails, linear, annular, atrophic, hypertrophic, actinic, inverse, eruptive, bullous, ulcerative, and lichen planus involving oral or vulvovaginal surfaces and certain overlap syndrome. So there is a wide variety of presentations in this disease. There is a long list of drugs that can induce lichen planus that include the antihypertensives like ACE inhibitors, beta blockers, nifedipine, methyl dopa. Then diuretics like hydrochlorothiazide, furosemide, spironolactone, several NSAIDs, then anti-epileptics like carbamazepine, phenothiazine, NTTT, ketoconazole, hydroxyurea, 5-fluorouracil, anti-malarial, sulfa drugs, gold bismuth, tumor necrotic factor alpha inhibitors, and sildenafil. So the lichenoid drug eruptions are characterized by all the changes of lichen planus plus eosinophilic infiltrate in the eosinophilic infiltrate among the band like infiltrate which we see at the dermoepidermal junction. So classical lichen planus has 5 P's. The papules of lichen planus are dry, shiny with white streaks which are known as Wickham's stripes. Lichen planus tend to favor the flexural surfaces of forearm, wrist and ankle. These are the common sites, wrists and ankles, and dorsal surfaces of hand, shin, trunk and sacral region, which is the less common site. Interestingly, face is rarely affected in classical lichen planus. It is affected in other kind of lichen planus, but not in classical lichen planus. So these are the class lesions of classical lichen planus. Up to 95% of the cases occur in adult and 5 to 10% of the cases occur in children. So it is predominantly an adult disease. Infant cases are rarely reported. The high proportion of cases suggests a genetic susceptibility for lichen planus. So familial lichen planus has also been reported. Pathogenicity of lichen planus lesions involve an autoimmune mediated lysis of basal keratinocytes by CD8 positive lymphocytes. Although the definitive etiological triggers are still not known, why CD8 positive lymphocytes reach the basal cells and why they selectively damage the basal cell, this phenomena is still not very clear. This is,
excuse me, sir.
हाँ
sir, kindly all trainees भी अगर आप unlock कर दें थोड़ी देर.
नहीं यार, मैं नहीं कर रहा unlock. जाने दे, जो नहीं आए वो नहीं है. So the lichen planus, this is the characteristic appearance of lichen planus, which is characterized by a band-like lymphohistiocytic infiltrate that is seen at the dermoepidermal junction. If we go to higher power, you can see here, this is hyperkeratosis. There is wedge-shaped hypergranulosis. Then there is basal cell vacuolar degeneration. The basal cell is not existent here. And you can see these colloid bodies. These are the dead or degenerated keratinocytes which have fallen into the dermis. Here the colloid bodies are becoming more obvious. So since the basal layer is damaged, along with basal layer, the melanocytes are also damaged. So once the melanocyte get damaged, the melanin which is present in the melanocyte falls into the dermis. And this is called as the pigmentary incontinence. And the melanin is engulfed by the macrophages. And hence these macrophages, you can see this nucleus of a macrophage which have engulfed this melanin. So these macrophages are called as melanophages. And finally, the typical band-like lymphohistiocytic infiltrate that is called to be obscuring the dermoepidermal junction. So management of classical cutaneous LP. Most cutaneous lichen planus lesions resolve spontaneously within a few years. Most of the patients come to you and ask that, Dr. Saab, when we are going to be all right from lichen planus. So my answer is that it's a disease with frequent remissions and exacerbations and a prolonged course. Around about 4 to 5 years or 6 years, it takes for these remissions to end. So it is possible that you can get rid of lichen planus, but it takes some time. So the typical treatment is with topical corticosteroids. When topical corticosteroids fail to control pruritus, then we can go for narrow band UVB therapy. Second line therapies include systemic retinoids, systemic steroids, topical tacrolimus, metronidazole, griseofulvin, and cyclosporine. Then third line therapies include PUVA, thalidomide, mycophenolate, mofetil, low molecular weight heparin, iontophoresis. Post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation, which is the most troublesome side effects of lichen planus, may take years to fade. Oral lichen planus. So most of you have come across this presentation. It can occur alone or can be a presenting sign of other variety of lichen planus. Whenever you find a lichen planus on the body, it is mandatory that you see the oral mucosa. And many a time in confusing lesions, the oral findings will help you make a confirmed diagnosis. The oral form affects female more than male and mostly in the middle age. Prevalence is 0.5 to 2.6. There is evidence that suggests that various addition molecules and cytokines, including tumor necrotic factor alpha and RENTES, may play a role in a complicated interaction among T cell, mast cells, and eosinophil in causing oral lichen planus. So the oral lichen planus can present in several forms. They can be reticular. Reticular is the common form which we see in the oral mucosa. which we call as the lace-like pattern. Then it could be erosive. You can see these erosive lesions, which are commonly confused with pemphigus vulgaris, the erosive-like implant. So just remember, if you find these erosive lesions, there will be some hint of lace-like pattern in the oral mucosa. Then the lesions can be atrophic and can be hypertrophic. Characteristic reticular lesions are bilateral and symmetrical with thin, slightly raised white lines or papules that form a lace-like pattern. Erosive oral ligand planus lesions present as large areas of irregular shaped ulceration with whitish pseudomembrane. Rather than confusing erosive LP with candidiasis, it is more close to pemphigus. This is a typical reticular or lace-like pattern of oral lichen planus. All of you must have seen many times this presentation. The features of oral lichen planus is not different from that of cutaneous lichen planus. There will be hyperkeratosis, acanthosis, basal cell degeneration, band-like infiltrate, but the pigmentary incontinence will be a little less as compared to, because the pigmentation is less in mucosa as compared to that on the skin. Erosive lesions are painful and subject to irritation by dental hygiene products like toothpaste, toothbrushes, and even by chewing gutkha, tobacco, betel nut, and leaves. Usually, such patients complain of difficulty in eating spicy and sour foods. Cutaneous and gentle involvement of lichen planus can precede, arise concurrently, or appear after development of oral lichen planus. So there are many differentials of oral lichen planus, but the common is pemphigus, bullous pemphigoid, then lupus symptomatosis, mucosal candidiasis, and sometimes malignant. Incidence of systemic diseases associated with oral lichen planus include hypertension, diabetes, hypothyroidism. Management. Primary goal is to relieve the symptoms and monitoring for changes suggestive of dysplasia. First line treatment is topical immunomodulators. We don't have topical retinoids, so commonly we give triamcinolone in Orabase, which is called as Canalog. Then in severe cases, you can give intralesional injection. Then systemic steroids and other immunosuppressives can be used. Then the third type of lichen planus, which again is a common type of lichen planus in which nails are involved. It is seen in 10% of patients in lichen planus, and sometimes nail lichen planus will be the only manifestation. In such cases, it will be confused with 20 nail dystrophy, nail lichen planus. Typical appears during fifth and sixth decade of life, and fingernails are involved more than toenails. The characteristic findings of nail lichen planus are longitudinal ridges, pitting, which is of course not common, onychorhexis, that is a splitting of nail, distal splitting, pregium formation, which is the typical feature, which is a form of scarring, and brown discoloration. Trachonychia and onycholysis may be present. If we do a biopsy from the nail LP, then it will have the classical finding of skin lichen planus. Differential diagnosis would include psoriasis, but psoriasis will have a lot of hyperkeratosis, lots of hyperkeratosis, oil drop sign, and pitting. Ridging and pregium formation is not seen. Onychomycosis, there will be hyperkeratosis, but again, no pregium formation. Alopecia areata is characterized by nail pitting and longitudinal or transverse striation. So these are the longitudinal ridging. Then here the trigium is seen, and now the whole nail is lost and scarring is seen in the nail bed. Untreated nail lichen planus may progress to anonychia. So diagnosis should be prompt and treatment should be quick. Conservative first-line treatment is superpotent topical corticosteroids, but usually unsuccessful. So the mainstay is intralesional steroids, which are given in the proximal nail fold. The dose will be 10 milligram per ml. And it is quite effective. It's painful. You can apply numbing cream on the proximal nail fold before giving the injection. Alternatively, systemic steroid therapy with oral prednisolone or intramuscular triamcinolone has also been provided with a good results. But according to my experience, intralesional corticosteroid is the mainstay of treatment. Then another variety of lichen planus, which we call as the linear. जी
सर ये नेल लाइकन प्लानस पेनफुल होता है मतलब पेशेंट जो है पेन के साथ प्रेजेंट कर सकता है
नहीं यूजुअली तो नहीं पेन तो यार किसी भी नेल की डिजीज में नहीं होता अनलेस कोई मैलिग्नेंसीज हो वरना क्या सोरेसिस का पेशेंट पेन के साथ प्रेजेंट करता है नो क्या ओनिकोमाइकोसिस का नो यूजुअली ये कॉस्मेटिक रिजल्ट्स ही होते हैं कॉस्मेटिक इफेक्ट्स ही होते हैं हाँ ऐसी जगह पे अगर कोई फाइंडिंग है फुट में जिस तरह बिग टो में जहां पे फुटवेयर से पेन हो रहा है तो अलग बात है सो लीनियर लाइकन प्लानस इज अ रेयर वेरिएंट दैट अफेक्ट फ्यूअर देन 1% ऑफ द पेशेंट सो इट कैन बी एट्रीब्यूटेड टू कॉबनर फिनोमेना और अकर एज सच अलोंग द डर्मोटोमल और ब्लेस्को लाइन्स Classically, linear lichen planus present as classical lichen planus papules, but these lichen planus papules are seen in a line or band pattern, usually unilateral and crudite. Sometimes the same ipsilateral mucosa may be involved. So the confusion may occur with lichen striatus. Lichen striatus is an important differential diagnosis. In classical lichen planus, linear lichen planus, the lesions are like lichen planus. They are just like lichen planus, but in a linear fashion. And in lichen striatus, the lesions are like eczema. You can call it them at like as lichenoid eczema, because scaling will be more prominent in lichen striatus as compared to linear lichen planus. Because lichen striatus is a mixture of eczema and lichen planus. So scaling, if you see in a linear lesion, quite a bit of scaling, then it is better to call it as lichen striatus rather than linear lichen planus. So linear psoriasis will be just like psoriasis, but in a linear fashion. So blescitis will be like inflammatory verrucous epidermal nevus. So treatment of linear lichen planus will be same as classical lichen planus by mid potency or potent topical steroids. Then annular lichen planus. 3 to 7% of lichen planus patient will present as annular lesions. So the why annular lesions occur cannot be we are not sure. So it can be seen that there convergence of multiple lichenoid papules in a circular shape. Or it can be because of expansion of papules or plaques with central involution and advancing. These are all theories that why annular lesions develop. So annular lichen planus lesions clinically present as red or purple circular macules or plaques with raised borders. With raised borders. And without central atrophy. So there is another variety of lichen planus, which is called as atrophic lichen planus. Just remember that in atrophic lichen planus, there will be atrophy in the center. But in annular lichen planus, the lesions or lichenoid lesions are in annular configuration. Just like in linear lichen planus, the lesions of lichen planus were in linear configuration. So annular lichen planus will have the same lesions as classical LP, but in annular fashion, without central atrium. Can be single, can be multiple. Genital lesions may occur on penis, scrotum. Sometimes generalized eruption have been documented. So the treatment pattern will be similar to classical lichen planus. Sometimes hydroxychloroquine and dapsone is also given in the treatment of lichen planus. Then atrophic lichen planus is different from annular lichen planus. It is rare variant, and there are this prevalence is unknown. The cutaneous lesions of atrophic lichen planus arise on skin affected by an earlier. So atrophic lichen planus develop in existing lichen planus, which progress to dark brown macule with marked atrophy. Usually, lichen planus heals with hyperpigmentation, or we can call it as post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation. But if the post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation, you see atrophy as well, then you will call it as atrophic lichen planus, rather than calling it as post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation. So the treatment is similar to other localized. Usually we avoid giving potent topical corticosteroids in atrophic lichen planus because skin is already atrophic. So here you can see the hyperpigmentation along with the atrophy. So this is atrophic or resolving lichen planus. Then another variety which we come across is hypertrophic lichen planus. Here now the lesions are thickened papules and plaques. Initially red, but later on they become violaceous. And common site are pre-tibial, ankle, and sometime on forearms. Very pruritic and quite chronic. So rare cases, there can be malignant transformation. So the common differential diagnosis of hypertrophic LP is chronic prurigo. Hypertrophic lichen planus, as the name signifies, there will be associated hypertrophy, hyperkeratosis, acanthosis, along with all the other typical findings of lichen planus at the basement membrane. So, topical corticosteroids under occlusion will be the first line treatment. Second line treatment will be intralesional corticosteroids. Then second line, we can give mycophenolate mofetil, acitretin intralesional corticosteroids, and cryotherapy. Low dose heparin can be given. Hyperpigmentation and scarring can be managed separately. Inverse lichen planus, like inverse psoriasis, inverse lichen planus affects the flexure or intertriginous zone, which is, of course, not a common site of lichen planus. So axilla can be involved, inguinal creases, gluteal cleft, lymph flexures, submemory region. Once LP occur in inverse distribution, it loses its typical morphology and present as erythematous, poorly defined lesions. So scales may be absent due to occlusive nature. Lesions at this site may lose. Just give me 2 minutes. I am taking a break for 2 minutes, please. Sorry again. So, in inverse lichen planus, the typical findings of lichen planus, that is, become striae and violaceous color is not seen. The lesions are usually erythematous with poorly defined borders. And keratotic papules or erosive lesions may be seen. So, like inverse psoriasis, the DD include inverse psoriasis and inverse infiltrate. Topical corticosteroids is the first line treatment, and in addition, tacrolimus can be given. Now, this is
sir, sorry to interrupt you. Sir, what are the DDs of inverse lichen planus?
Inverse lichen planus ki DD wahi hai jo inverse lesions ki hoti hai, jaise ke erosive candidiasis ya inverse psoriasis. क्योंकि इसके टिपिकल मॉर्फोलॉजी नहीं रहती लाइकन पेनिस की, थोड़ी सी इरिथीमेटस लीजन्स हो जाते हैं. तो अनलेस वी गो फॉर अ स्किन बायोप्सी और वी सी लीजन्स एल्सवेयर, इट विल बी नॉट इजी टू डायग्नोज द इनवर्स लाइकन पेनिस. इरप्टिव लाइकन पेनिस, समटाइम्स वी कम अक्रॉस पेशेंट्स हु डेवलप मल्टीपल लीजन्स ऑफ लाइकन पेनिस सडनली, जिसको हम जनरलाइज्ड एलपीपी कहते हैं. So it is, can be called as exanthematous or generalized lichen planus. So it presents as rapidly spreading, disseminated, erythematous, flat top, polygonal papules or macules that become umbilicated and take a violaceous color. Lesion may appear over the trunk and all four extremities. And such kind of eruptive lichen planus is seen more commonly with hepatitis C. So whenever you see an eruptive LP, the hepatitis C and hepatitis B should be ordered in all cases of lichen planus, but particularly in case of eruptive lichen planus. Management. Eruptive lichen planus require a systemic therapy. So my favorite is giving a shot of triamcinolone, but you can give oral corticosteroids as well. Uva therapy can also be given. So topical corticosteroids, cyclosporin, systemic rifampicin can be given, and as well as acitretin. Etritinate is no longer available. Spontaneous resolution occur after 8 weeks. Now comes the bullous lichen planus. You see, all the lichen planus can be associated with Max Joseph clade formation. It is a small cleft which is seen at the subepidermal region. Bullous lichen planus is a rare variant characterized by development of vesicobullous lesion. So in bullous lichen planus, this Max Joseph cleft expands and form a well-formed subepidermal blister. So the histology I'll discuss later on, but typically the bullies are seen over the lesions of existing lichen planus. Leg is the common site. The bullous lichen planus is difficult to distinguish from lichen planus pemphigoides, but the difference is lichen planus pemphigoides is two diseases together, that is lichen planus and pemphigoid. The lesions of pemphigoid coexist with lesions of lichen planus, so the blisters will not be seen over lichenoid lesions. Blisters will be separate and lichen planus lesions will be separate. This is lichen planus pemphigoides. But in bullous lichen planus, The blisters will be seen on the top of lichen planus lesion. So the immunofluorescence will be negative in bullous lichen planus. Treatment of bullous lichen planus is similar to other lichen planus. So what we see in bullous lichen planus, there is atrophic epidermis, loss of basal keratinocytes, then there's a huge max dose of clot which is amounted to a subepidermal blister. And beneath this blister, there is a band-like lymphohistiocytic infiltrate. There will be pigmentary incontinence here. There will be colloid bodies here. So all the findings of lichen planus, these are colloid bodies, will be seen beneath the blister. Ulcerative lichen planus. Ulcerative lichen planus is very similar to erosive lichen planus. The only difference is that we use the rubber term erosive in mucosal lesions. But you can use it interchangeably with ulcerative lesion. Etiology behind ulcerative lesion is poorly understood. But metoprolol and erosive LP can coexist because of metoprolol. So such kind of painful ulcers can be seen on plantar surfaces. Such kind of lichen planus is also called as erosive lichen planus. So if such kind of lesions occur, it would be definitely painful. Management by tacrolimus, by topical corticosteroids, by ultraviolet hand and foot PUVA or total body PUVA or UVB. So sometimes we have to resort to oral retinoids. A lichen planus, when occurs on palm and soles, it will be in the differential diagnosis of punctate keratoderm. So the other causes of punctate keratoderma are callosities, it is warts, syphilis, or arsenical keratosis. So lichen planus, as you can see here, the lesions are punctate, it occurs on palm and soles, and in punctate keratodermas, we see callosities, wart, arsenical keratosis, and syphilis sometimes, not psoriasis. Lichen planus pigmentosus, which is called as LPPI. LPP, we have reserved it for lichen planus, lichen planopilaris. So LPPI is lichen planus pigmentosus. Uncommon variety that affect all races, but seems to favor the dark skinned individuals. More common in Indian and Middle Eastern population. And more frequent in females, and commonly in third and fourth decades. It is possible that pigmentation of these lesions is a result of extensive melanin incontinence. Viral infections, particularly hepatitis C, may be the cause. So is carbohydrate, impaired carbohydrate metabolism. Then some drugs like mustard oil, alma oil, henna, and sun exposure can be a trigger. But frankly, there is no definitive cause. Typically, LPPI involves hyperpigmented dark brown macules that are often asymptomatic, non-itchy. Usually sun-exposed site like face, neck, upper extremity. Flexure involvement have been occurred. Pigmentation pattern within the lesion is diffuse, while reticulate, blotchy, or linear or perifollicular pattern is known. There will be always difficulty in diagnosing lichen planus pigmentosus from melasma. And what I will say to you, that melasma is typically on the malar areas, nose and cheek. However, lichen planus pigmentosus does not follow any specific pattern. Secondly, melasma can be epidermal, that will be a brown color, and it can be dermal, that will be violaceous or bluish in color. So if the pigmentation is brown color, there is no doubt that it is not lichen planus pigmentosus. So lichen planus pigmentosus can be confused with dermal melasma, but never epidermal melasma. And secondly, lichen planus pigmentosus usually involve, along with face, neck, and upper extremities, and even chest. So if the lesion is extensively involving neck and chest, this is not a presentation of melasma. Lichen planus pigmentosus may have longer clinical course than other variants of lichen planus. First line therapies are similar to the classical lichen planus. So by topical corticosteroids and tacrolimus, along with acitretin, phototherapy should be avoided as there is increased risk of pigmentation. So if in early cases, you don't pick it as lichen planus pigmentosus and treat those cases as melasma, then they will become more permanent and difficult to eradicate. Another name of lichen planus pigmentosus is erythema dyschromicum persistens or ascidermatosus. Usually these changes in epidermis or basal layer is subtle. You can see a few vacuolated basal cells, but there will not be very frank basal cell degeneration. However, pigmentary incontinence will be prominent, and secondly, band-like infiltrate will not be as prominent as in other varieties of lichen planus. Then we come to lichen planopilaris. It's a morphological variant of lichen planus involving the hair follicle and is a cause of primary lymphocytic secretory alopecia. Common in Caucasians and Indian population. Affected females are 1.8 to 1. It's an inflammatory response mediated by T lymphocyte targeting follicular antigen. There can be causes there can be causes because of infection and stress, but nothing is fine. Just a minute, please. Safi? Salaam, Safi. Tumne do clear kar diye. So clinically, patient with lichen planopilaris present with whitish atrophic or scarring patches. And sometimes even the violaceous color atrophic patches are also seen with the itching, scaling, burning and tenderness. So the anagen's hairs can be easily pulled. They can be single or multiple lesions with a long, prolonged course. Three groups of lichen planopilaris exist: the classical, frontal fibrosing alopecia, and Gram-Little Picardy Leisure syndrome. Sometimes lichen planopilaris can be extra scalp, extra cranial, can be on trunk and even on limbs. Frontal fibrosing alopecia progress as band-like scarring with hair loss on the frontal hairline. Gram-Little Picardy Leisure syndrome is a triad of secretory alopecia, lichen planus of the skin with non-scarring hair loss of axilla and pubic area. Rare syndrome. This is lichen planopilaris. Typically characterized by lichenoid lesions involving the follicles. Here you can see many follicular lesions and hair loss. There is loss of hairs as well. This is one of the early phases of lichen planopilaris. You can see this erythematous color. If you see this erythematous color in secretricial patches, it means the lesions are active. When they turn into violaceous or bluish, it means the lesions are becoming quiescent. Lichen planopilaris is characterized by follicular plugging. The follicular plugging is also seen in DLE. But the typical findings of lichen planus are seen below the hair follicles, but not in the skin intervening between the hair follicles. On contrary, DLE will be seen throughout the skin biopsy. The interface change will be seen throughout the skin biopsy. So in lichen planopilaris, the basal cell vacuolative degeneration is seen only in the follicular epithelium with band-like lymphohistiocytic infiltrate. This is a closer view. You can see the follicular plugging. Now the basal layer is lost. This is Max Joseph cleft. This is band-like lymphohistiocytic infiltrate. In DLE, there is perivascular and periadenexal infiltrate. So periadenexal infiltrate is not seen in lichen planopilaris. Management. We have to treat it promptly, otherwise once the secretricial alopecia sets in, then there is no treatment. Then we give topical corticosteroids, superpotent, or intralesional corticosteroids. Tetracycline derivatives of topical tacrolimus can be used, oral corticosteroids can be used, hydroxychloroquine may be used in resistant cases, then cyclosporine and mycophenolate mofetil. Other therapies are rarely used like systemic retinoids, rizatriptan, thalidomide, dapsone, minoxidil, all controversial. Vulvovaginal lichen planus is similar to erosive lichen planus of oral mucosa, largely affecting Caucasian women and characterized by development of vulval intraepithelial neoplasm. The characteristic feature is chronic course and unexplained exacerbations, improvements, and remission. Women with vulvovaginal LP present with complaints of genital irritation, itching, burning, soreness, and dyspareunia, sometimes with purulent discharge from the vagina. Physical examination shows inflamed, erythematous, or eroded epithelium. Later on, transform into reticulate, white, gray, lacy pattern like we see in oral mucosa. Later on, vulval adhesions and stenosis may occur. The differential diagnosis is LSA in plasma cell bulbitis, autoimmune vesicobulous disease. So we treat it with oral prednisolone, other topical corticosteroid, low dose methotrexate. Sometimes we give steroid vaginal suppositories or topical calcineurin inhibitors. Second line would be called cyclosporine, rizatriptan, thalidomide, hydroxychloroquine. Actinic lichen planus is another variety of lichen planus in which you see the violaceous lesions with a white halo. Middle-aged patients and seen on the sun-exposed areas. They can be annular, pigmented, or dyschromic. Pigmentary form present as hypermelanotic. The pigmentary form of actinic lichen planus is lichen planus pigmentosus. Diagnosis is made by distribution on the sun-exposed areas and having a typical halo surrounding the pigmented lesions which is not seen in lichen planus pigmentum. So sun avoidance and topical corticosteroid is the main treatment. Sometimes we go for intradigital corticosteroid and topical cyclosporin or picrolimus. Lichen planus lupus erythematosus overlap syndrome. It's a rare variety in which both the lesions of lichen planus and LE will be seen. Distal arm, leg, face, and trunk may be involved. We can see a butterfly rash and classical lichen planus on extremity. Management is similar to other variety of lichen planus. I have told you that lichen planus pemphigoides is the two diseases in one patient, that is pemphigoids and lichen planus. There will be histological and immunopathological features of both classical LP and bullous pemphigoid. So here, the lichen planus lesions and bullous pemphigoid lesions will be coexisting. Here, these are the typical lichen planus, and here, the lesions are that of bullous pemphigoid. Epidermis, subepidermal blister with eosinophils. So the lesions will be tense bully, affecting both uninvolved skin and skin affected by prior or current lichenoid eruption. Management is to treat existing lichen planus and avoid further immunostimulation. And treat alternatively, lesions may be treated as bullous pemphigoid with topical or oral corticosteroids. Conclusion, lichen planus is inflammatory skin disease with characteristic clinical and histological features. In addition to classical lichen planus, there are different varieties of lichen planus. The classical lichen planus will present as 5P, but other varieties will have morphological differentiation. Histopathology is generally consistent. Management of classical lichen planus is mainly by topical corticosteroids, and second line will be systemic steroids, intralesional corticosteroids, and other immunosuppressants. Then there are a few related diseases. One of those is lichen nitidus. Lichen nitidus can be differentiated from lichen planus in that the lesions of lichen nitidus are micropapules rather than classical polygonal papules of lichen planus. These pinhead side papules are usually skin colored and asymptomatic with flat shiny surfaces. So some authors favor separation of two dermatoses because of histopathological differences. So these usually remain discrete, although sometimes they are closely grouped. Linear lichen nitidus have been described. Nail pitting may coexist with lichen nitidus, and actinic variety of lichen nitidus is also documented, which is called as lichen nitidus actinicus. This is lichen nitidus. These are the pinhead papules, mainly skin colored or flesh colored or shiny. The histology is characterized by a central depression. Then one or two retinages are involved with typical band-like lymphocytic infiltrate and a basal cell vacuolar degeneration. Epidermis on both sides is show deep retinages in form of cloying. Sometimes you see granuloma formation within this infiltrate. This granuloma is not seen in band-like infiltrate of normal lichen planus. Sometimes even giant cells are seen. I have explained you the lichen striatus, which is histological and clinical mix between eczema and lichen planus. You can see spongiosis along with interface dermatitis. So the last is the Nickem disease, which is keratosis lichenoides chronicus. This is characterized by violaceous, papular or nodular lesions, typically arranged in linear or reticulate pattern, most marked on the extremities and buttocks, accompanied by seborrheic dermatitis like eruption on the face. So the lichen planus lesions in reticulate or linear distribution on extremities and buttocks. Oral manifestations are recurrent abscess ulcers, large chronic ulcers, and erythrokeratotic papules. Nail may be involved. Histological features can be of chronic dermatitis or be lichen planus. So it is an unusual variant of lichen planus. And whether it's a distinct variety or a type of lichen planus, it's still under debate. So that's all from for today. If there are any questions, you may ask.
Sir, I have a question. Hello. Sir, मुझे पूछना था कि lichen planus और lichen planus और lichenoid drug eruption एक ही चीज को कहेंगे या फिर वो अलग lichenoid drug eruption अलग से जब कहेंगे या lichen
मुझे थोड़ा lichenoid drug eruption will be like lichen planus. The only difference will be once we do the histology among the band like lymphohistiocytic infiltrate there will be prominent eosinophils. क्योंकि आपको lichen planus बताया तो lichen planus की जो main etiology है वो drugs है. So drugs बहुत सारी drugs lichen planus के lesions कर सकती हैं. Lichen planus के lesions वैसे ही होंगे जैसे lichen planus के classical lichen planus के lesions. फर्क सिर्फ histology में.
Thank you sir. Sir another question. Sir आपने बताया कि UVB use करेंगे अगर हमारे पास वो topical corticosteroid अगर effective नहीं होता
तो sir genital lichen planus में eruptive lichen planus
अच्छा
या erosive lichen planus
sir वैसे नहीं.
हाँ वैसे तो आपको पता ही है lichen planus control हो जाता है इतना कोई बड़ी problem नहीं है. lichen planus difficult lichen planus कौन सा है जी? Oral lichen planus is a difficult lichen planus. lichen planus pigmentosus is a difficult lichen planus. Lichen planopilaris is a difficult lichen planus. These are the difficult lichen planus which are cosmetically troublesome and unresponsive to people. कहाँ कर सकते हैं कैसे कर सकते हैं नहीं कर सकते तो वो ना वो जगह ऐसी नहीं है ना आप ओरल म्यूकोजा में नैरो बैंड यूवीबी दे सकते हैं ना वेजाइना के अंदर दे सकते हैं तो फिर आपको ना अगर कॉर्टिकोस्टेरॉइड से ऊपर जाना पड़ेगा ना तो आपको इम्यूनो सप्रेसिव देनी पड़ेगी. इरोजिव लाइकन पेरिस में हाइड्रोक्सी क्लोरोक्विन का भी रोल डेप्सोन का भी रोल है थैलिडोमाइड का भी रोल इन एडिशन टू अदर इम्यूनो सप्रेसिव एजेंट्स लाइक साइक्लोस्पोरिन. बस कर लें चलो.
यस
चलो थैंक यू वेरी मच टेक केयर और अल्लाह हाफिज़. खुदा
हाफिज़. थैंक यू सर.